Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again, and hoping the grace and the mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. Now, before we enter into today's classic, I just want to give you a brief recap of what we covered last time. Last time, we covered quite a number of presentations, but I'm coming from a season that is continuous, which is the realms and the dimensions in the spirit, in which we have entered different dimensions of spiritual realms, and I presented many diversities of realms and many angles of dimensions in the spirit, realms of atmospheres, the realms of the dead, the multiverse. We went in different dimensions in the spirit, explaining the spirit mysteries in the diversities of different realms that are both in the physical and in the spirit. And today we want to enter into the heaven realms and dimensions. Earlier on in the last presentation, which was the realms and dimensions part 6, I explained about the heavenly atmospheres, but I did not explain about the ultimate heavens. I explained about the first, the second, and the third heavens, but I did not explain the ultimate level of the heavens of God. And hoping that today I'm going to take you not only in the heavenly dimensions, which are the heavens of God, but I'll be stretching, revealing the heaven itself. So I'm hoping that the Spirit of God is going to allow me to explain all the hidden details, all the information that pertains to the heavens of God, which is the emphasis in the realms and dimensions of heaven. And I'm explaining the heavens of God, and we are coming from different chapters, different segments, and different partitions of explanations, where we explained different realms and dimensions from part 1, and this is now the heavens of God, which is now part 7. Let us get into the book of Revelations, chapter 4, verse 1. Book of Revelations, chapter 4, verse 1. After this I looked, and behold, a door was opened in heaven. And the first voice which I heard was as if it were a trumpet talking with me, which said, come up hither, and I will show you things which must be here and after. And out of the throne proceeded lightnings and thunderings and voices. And before I go any further, the lightnings, the thunderings, and the various voices, those are manifestations of projections that manifest different echoes, different voices of one God. This is why you realize that God is a manifestation of different voices. He is a manifestation of different sounds. He is a manifestation of different languages. And out of the throne proceeded lightnings and thunderings and voices, and there were seven lamps of fire burning before the throne of God, which are the seven spirits of God. And those seven lamps, which are the seven spirits of God, are the representation of the seven churches. And the seven churches are also represented by the seven angels. And those seven churches, they resemble also seven different voices of God. And in those seven churches are the manifestations of seven different characters of God, where God manifests himself in seven different dimensions. And before the throne, there was a sea of glass like unto crystal. And in the midst of the throne and round about the throne were four beasts full of eyes before and behind. Why? Because God is watching all over. His eyes are watching not only in heaven, but they are watching in heaven and on earth and also on the firmament. Between the heaven and the earth, there is another realm which is called the firmament. Between heaven and earth, there is also another realm, and that realm is of three heavens. Before we talk about other heaven dimensions which are located inside the realm of the firmament, which are the lower heavens, we have got the lower heavens, and the lower heavens are partitioned in different categories of heavens inside the firmament. And we have got the higher heavens, which are the first, the second, and the third heaven. And then we have the ultimate heaven, where Lucifer believed that he could raise his throne and reach the uppermost heavenly places, where the throne of God was located and where the throne of God is located. And this is the heaven which John was shown, where he saw the four beasts full of eyes before and behind. And the first beast was like a lion. The lion represents the Lion of Judah, who's none other than Christ himself. The lion represents also the domain or the dominance of God on the lower part of the heavens, who rules not only in heaven but on earth. This is why he was called the Lion of Judah, the Lion of the tribe of Judah. And there was not only a lion, there was also an eagle. And the fourth beast was like an eagle, a flying eagle. The eagle represents his dominance in the realms and dimensions of different heavens under the ultimate heaven. The eagle represents the rank and the ranks of all angels that rule on the firmament, the principalities, the powers. And remember, the principalities and the powers, they don't begin in the firmament. They are also there in heaven. And even the principalities and the powers that are explained in the book of Ephesians, which are now ranks of demons, those were ranks of angels that then became demons. But the significance of principalities and powers, those are ranks of angels, not only ranks of demons. And they are signified by the eagle, which flies in the air.
and rules the air. I'm not talking about the ranks of the prince of the powers of the air, which is now the prince who is fallen, who is none other than Lucifer the devil. And there was also another beast whose face had a face as that of a man. The face that appeared as the face of a man is the dominance of God in the image of man. And the dominance of God in the image of a man is the dominance that of Adam. Adam, who was created by God the Father, the Son, Christ, and the Holy Spirit, when they said, "Let us make man in our own image." And they created their image in the image of a man. And this is the dominance of God as man. This is why man was declared as a God. That is the lesser part of God. The reflection of God on this lower realm, who is given the power and the authority to rule over this earth. And I'm talking about the actual dominance that was given unto man way before man lost the capacity and the authority that he was given by God. I'm talking about the man that is given the identity of God, the likeness of God, but in the form of the beast that then appeared as a man. And the four beasts had each of them six wings about him, and they were full of eyes within. And they rest not day and night, saying, "Holy, holy, Lord God Almighty." Those four beasts, they represent the image, the character, the identity, the manifestation, the dimensions of God, not only in heaven, but on the firmament, as explained, in the first heaven, in the second heaven, in the third heaven, and on the last dimension, which is the realm of this earth. And we haven't even explained about the angels that represent the spiritual beings that reside in heaven. We're explaining about just the throne of God and its manifestation. The throne of God has a different level of manifestations that begin in heaven, where the throne of God is located. And the throne of God does not dwell in the uppermost places in heaven only. It manifests its glory from the ultimate dimensions of the higher heavens and the first heavens and the second heavens and the third heavens and all the categories of heavens, the fourth, the fifth, the sixth heavens, which are now the heavens where you encounter the fallen angels, which hijack the fourth, the fifth heavens, where you encounter the generals of God, where you encounter the principalities, where you encounter the powers. All those are heaven dimensions. And in all those dimensions, they are principalities, which are resembled by watchers, the elevated spirits of God, which are watchers that watch day and night, representing the kingdom of God and representing God himself. And the watchers are there to safeguard, to represent, to watch over the kingdom of God, that which represents heaven and that which is under the ultimate heaven. And then they are the gatekeepers after the principalities and powers, which are the watchers. And remember, I've already explained to you that the principalities and powers, those are the ranks that are represented by the eagle. The eagle flies in the air. The beast that appeared as the eagle. Why? Because it is the rank of the firmaments, the rank of the category that represents the princes and the powers. This is why the scriptures talk about the prince who rules the powers of the air, the prince who rules the principalities of the air. There is also the prince of peace, who has got his own princes that rule in the air on behalf of the kingdom of light. And that is the ultimate level, which is represented by the eagle. And they are spirits that represents the air, the realm where you don't see anything visible, but they are kingdoms that are made manifest if you tap into that spiritual realm. And then there is the realm of not only watchers, but the realm of intercessors, which is the realm where battles happen in the spirit, the realm of generals in the spirit, who safeguard those that dwell here on earth, the ascended spirits of God, those that guard the firmaments, they guard from the fourth to the fifth to the sixth realm, which represents the categories of the heavens. That's the realm where you see the generals of God who have been elevated by God, who dwell and reign under the elevated angels. And that realm is a realm where you see angels that also guard the four corners of the earth. They guard this whole realm of the earth. And that is in Revelation chapter 7, verse 1. And after these things, I saw four angels standing on the four corners of the earth, holding the four winds of the earth. They are angels that guard, angels that represent the militia of God in the spirit. And those angels, they guard not only the four corners of the earth. Those are the angels that proclaim the glory of God. In Revelation chapter 5, verse 2, and I saw a strong angel. Why a strong angel? Why? Because there are categories of angels in the realms of the firmament, which are headed by Angel Michael, the gatekeepers. We have the watchers in the spirit, which are represented by the eagle. The gatekeepers, they are represented by Angel Michael. Angel Michael that oversees the security of the heavens, the security of the firmaments, the security in this realm of the earth. The angels that wrestle in the spirit. When Daniel was praying, there were angels that were praying, that were wrestling. While Daniel was interceding and they were battling in the spirit. These are the angels also in heaven, which are always saying holy, holy, holy throughout, and they are worshiping throughout, and the manifestation of the glory of God is continuous. And we have the gatekeepers. The gatekeepers are not the interceding spirits. The gatekeepers are the angels that stood on the entrance of the gate that led into the Garden of Eden, and also the exit out of the Garden of Eden, and they held two flaming swords to guard that territory. Those angels, they are also there in heaven. In Revelation chapter 21 verse 12, it talks about the construction of the first heaven, which had a wall which John the Revelator saw, which had a great and high wall and 12 gates, and the gates had 12 angels, and the 12 angels, they were guarding that dimension in the spirit. And those 12 gates which are in the first heaven, which guard the first heaven, they are the angels representing every gate, which are also represented by the 12 disciples. Remember, I explained about the beast which had a face as that of a man. This is now the domain of man. Why? Because the domain of man is given unto the first heaven, where the disciples shall rule. When Jesus talks about my Father's house, which has got many mansions, he's not talking about mansions. He's talking about different heavens. We can be having seven heavens before we talk about the ultimate heaven of God. And some of those heavens, they've already been hijacked by demons. But those heavens, they belong to the sons of God, which are both the heaven angels in different categories of heavens, and the sons of men and the sons of angels, and the spirits that ascend into the highest realms. I talked about the ascending realms of the spirits of God, which ascend from these lower realms. And I saw in Daniel chapter 4 verse 18, I saw in the visions of my head upon my bed, and behold, a watcher and a holy one came down from heaven. He was explaining the vision that he had, but there was a holy watcher. And the watchers, like I explained, they are in different heavens. Until we reach this lower realm, they are also watchers. Those that don't stand on the pulpit, those that are not seen in the physical, but they are always being used by God to stand in the realms of the spirit to just watch. In Israel, there was a man who was like a watcher, who would stand just to guard, to see any approaching enemy. And we have the preachers. And now, when we are now talking about the preachers and teachers, we are talking about those that speak on behalf of God. And those that speak on behalf of God, they are also there in heaven. And this is why that every time when John would see a vision, there were elders, the 24 elders, who would be preaching day and night preaching and teaching the glory of God. I once explained about a vision where I saw the generals of God in the realms of the spirit in a certain heavenly dimension, and they are still preaching. The 12 disciples, they are there in the realms. They did not only preach on this dimension when Christ had descended here. They are still preaching in the realms. But in those realms, they are now preaching God. They are now preaching the glory of God. And they are preaching different levels of glories. Child of God, I have explained the throne of God. And on that throne of God, John talks about seeing thousands of angels. Not just tens of thousands, but thousands and thousands of angels. And they are angels, archangels, that represent the dimension where the throne of God is located. And those angels that are on that realm, they are not very many. They are mighty angels, which are gods, God angels, and they are worshiping angels. And they are archangels, and they are angels that represent just the glory of God, and they are angels that represent the manifestation of God, angels that represent the voice of God, and angels that represent the armies of heaven. Child of God, I have explained the realms of God and the dimensions. The heavens of the first, the second, the third, the fourth, the fifth, the sixth, and the seventh. I've explained about the firmaments. I explained about the watchers in the firmament. I explained also about the princes in the firmaments. I explained also the realm which is here on earth, where they are also strong angels and generals of God that represent this realm and the four corners. And when Lucifer fell, he took every capacity which represents all those heavens and the structures of heaven. He fell with the structures of heaven and came and structured his own kingdom down here. So when you continue going deep, there's also the first hell, the second hell, the third hell, up until you reach the realm where Lucifer's throne is located, which is now another kingdom going downwards. So we're talking about the kingdom of God, and we talk about the God kingdom. When I talk about the kingdom of God, we are talking about the kingdom of God which accommodates the sons of God, the angels of God, the generals of God, and all other creatures of God. When we talk about the God kingdom, we are talking about the not the kingdom of God, but a kingdom which is ruled by God in heaven. Not the kingdom of God, but the God kingdom. The God kingdom is now represented by the heavens of God, which is the emphasis of the dimension which I'm explaining today, which I explained its manifestation from the ultimate heaven of God up until this level. Child of God, I hope you have understood the realms and dimensions of the heavens of God in this part 7 dimension. In the name of Jesus.